करडम अजित नारायण राव, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, विजयनगर कॉलेज, होस्पेटे. टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस द कंडीशन फॉर अक्रोमैटिज्म ऑफ टू थिन लेंसेस सेपरेटेड बाय अ फाइनाइट डिस्टेंस. इफ टू थिन लेंसेस आर ऑफ द सेम मटेरियल, देयर अक्रोमैटिक कॉम्बिनेशन इज पॉसिबल ओनली इफ दे आर सेपरेटेड बाय अ फाइनाइट डिस्टेंस. Let us consider two thin lenses L1 and L2 of focal length F1 and F2, which are being separated by a distance and are mounted coaxially. When they are mounted coaxially separated by distance, then the mean focal length of the combination is given by. The mean focal length of the combination is given by 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1. Plus 1 by F2 minus X by F1 F2. Now we have to differentiate this complete equation. Differentiation of this component, it can be done like this. Differentiation of 1 by F, it is similar to differentiation of 1 by X. Differentiation of 1 by X is minus 1 by X square, and differentiation of X is given by dx. That is nothing but differentiation of 1 by x is minus dx by x square. In the same way, differentiation of 1 by f is given by minus df by f square. Similarly, differentiation of 1 by f1 is minus df1 by f1 square, and differentiation of 1 by f2 is minus df2 by f2 square. And to differentiate this component, we have to done by UV method. That is, for first term, we have to take minus x by f2 is common. Differentiation of 1 by f1 is minus df1 by f1 square. Similarly, for the second term, minus x by f1 is constant. Differentiation of f2, that is 1 by f2, is minus df2 by f2 square. In this particular expression, we do refer the term minus df by f1 is equal to omega 1 minus df2 by f2 is equal to omega 2, where omega 1 and omega 2 are the dispersive power of the two lenses which are being mounted coaxially, which are separated by distance. In other words, this component of minus df1 by f1 square can be written as omega 1 by f1. That means we know that minus df1 by f1 is omega 1. Minus df1 by f1 square is omega 1 by f1. That is, we get this value of f1 here, one additional f1 here. Similarly, minus df2 by f2 square is given by omega 2 by f2. Where omega 1 and omega 2 are the dispersive power of the first and second lenses respectively. Now, on replacing these particular terms in this above expression, we get this as minus df by f square is equal to omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2 minus x by f2 into omega 1 by f1 minus x by f1 into omega 2 by f2. Or in other words, it can be written as minus df by f square is equal to. Now, if you take these two terms, if it will take LCM, taking LCM f1 and f2, then we have to cross multiply omega 1 f2 plus omega 2 f1. This is the first term we get here. Similarly, for the next term, you are observing between these two terms, x is common, f1 and f2 is common. That is, if I do take minus x by f1 f2 as common, you get this as first term is omega 1, next is given by plus omega 2. Because when I take minus sign common, you get plus sign here. Minus into plus is minus again. Therefore, it can be written as minus x omega 1 plus omega 2 by f1 f2. In other words, the cumulative term is given by minus df by f square is equal to omega 1 f2 plus omega 2 f1 by f1 f2 minus x into omega 1 plus omega 2 by f1 f2. For achromatic combination, f should be same for both violet and red colors. That the change in the focal length must be zero. That means when the change in focal length is zero, in other words, the value of delta f is zero. Delta f means change in focal length, that becomes zero. That means when this component is 0, that means if you do refer back to the previous expression, here if I put df is 0, this complete component is 0. As this component is 0, if you replace this component here, that is bm 0, that means these two terms remain same here. That is omega 1 f2 plus omega 2 f1 by f1 f2 minus x into omega 1 plus omega 2 by f1 f2, that is equal to 0. Now we have to simplify. To simplify this, here if you take f1 f2 which is being transferred to the right hand side, then this component becomes 0 and you get only term omega 1 f2 plus omega 2 f1 minus x into omega 1 plus omega 2 is equal to 0, or the value of x is equal to omega 1 f2 plus omega 2 f1 by omega 1 plus omega 2. When the two thin lenses are of the same material, if they are of the same material, then omega 1 is equal to omega 2. That means if omega 1 is equal to omega 2, under this condition if I do consider omega 1 is equal to omega 2 is equal to omega, then x is equal to omega f2 plus omega f1 by omega plus omega, or that is equal to omega into f1 plus f2 by 2 omega, omega cancels, you get this as f1 plus f2 divided by 2. Therefore, under this condition, this value of x is equal to f1 plus f2 divided by 2. Thus, the condition for achromatism of two thin coaxial lenses made of the same material and are separated by distance is that the distance between the two lenses must be equal to the mean focal length of two thin lenses. The same principle is used in Huygens eyepiece. In the Huygens eyepiece, the focal length of the components are 3f and f, which are being separated by distance. Under this condition, the value of x is equal to 3f plus f divided by 2, that is equal to 2f. This equation does not involve dispersive power, and hence the combination has the same focal length for all the colors. Therefore, when a ray of white light parallel to the axis passes through the lens system, all the colors suffers the same amount of deviation. Hence, the images of all colors appears to be of the same size. However, the positions of different colors are different. Now, the monochromatic aberrations are of 5 types. They are spherical aberration, coma, astigmatism, distortion and curvature. Now we shall see what is the spherical aberration. The inability of the lens to form a point image of an axial point is called as spherical aberration. In this spherical aberration, you are observing that marginal ray suffers greater deviation than paraxial rays. I mean, here in when we refer back to this particular figure, you have a lens here. When a point object which one produces the ray of light, now you are observing that these are the marginal rays. These marginal rays produces greater deviation and produces the image which is nearer to the lens. And that these are the paraxial rays where the image is being formed farthest from the lens. Therefore, the image formed by the marginal rays is nearer than the image formed by the paraxial rays. The spherical aberration is eliminated by using parabolic mirrors. By using convex and concave lens in contact, spherical aberration can be minimized. Spherical aberration can be eliminated by using two thin lenses, such as plane or convex lenses, separated by distance. The distance is such that it is nothing but the difference in the focal length of two lenses. And the spherical aberration is positive for convex and negative for concave lens.